I wonder if the panel could tell us why they think the North Koreans sank the Cheonan.
There are several different reasons that have been posited, speculated. One is that it was in response to a conflict that occurred last November in the same area where a North Korean ship sank and there was a loss of life. There's also a lot of speculation connecting this to the succession process, that this might be considered to be a kind of hazing rite of initiation for new designated North Korean leaders to engage in some kind of incident internationally that challenges, in particular, South Korea. I actually think that one of the main reasons for this was that the North Koreans realized that South Korea was kind of moving forward without the North in its own diplomacy, and it was essentially a signal to the South, don't leave us behind. Don't think that you're going to be able to pursue your global agenda without dealing with us. You have to either continue to provide the same kind of structured relationship, including payments that had existed for the past 10 years, or you have to find some other way of engaging with us at a higher priority than the current South Korean administration has engaged.
If I can piggyback on that, if I may, I kind of think it's a combination of two things. But let me lay the groundwork. As you all know, that Kim Jong-il had a health incident in August of 2008, which we believe to have been a stroke. I think from that point on, the North Koreans had become very defensive. They are not in a position to compromise. There is a vulnerability going on there as they seek to put in place what they have not formally had up to now in a succession plan. So their ability to walk back, their ability to blink, their ability to compromise, their ability to finalize an agreement at the end of the Bush administration, all of which fall into this, we cannot internally be seen weak. And so when this incident that Scott referred to on the 10th of November of 2009 occurred, I think the North Koreans were in a position of, all right, we have got to respond to this. We're going to do it harshly. It is a reflection of our strength, the potential for the regime continuity. And so the what we had seen before in 1999 and in 2002 in the same area was exaggerated because of the internal situation with North Korea, and thus leading to a disproportionate response, a retaliation of a deliberate and murderous magnitude.